Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video we are going to talk about skincare because moisturizers and serums can be a little heavy for summer, so I thought I'll pick and choose and tell you my favorite skincare products which are also very suitable for summer. So when it comes to skincare, I talk about a product which is I know for sure is flattering for most of the skin types across, you know, all skin types. I have extremely sensitive, acne-prone combination skin. So a little bit of something wrong in my skincare can just trigger my skin very, very instantly. So I'm very, very careful about what I put on my skin. So if I'm talking about a product, then that means the product does not have any nasty ingredients or it does not irritate the skin. Of course, there are always people who might react to certain things. It's not like if it's suiting me, it has to suit you. But if I talk about a product, it's usually most flattering to most of the skin types. So yeah, I just wanted to put that out there. But again, always every skin type is different. So if you do end up purchasing these things, then do a patch test before you would want to try it. And of course, like if you're using actives in your skincare for the first time, then you should know that your skin will definitely purge. So sometimes you are trying a new serum, let's say you're trying a new lactic acid or niacinamide, your skin is going to break out first to get used to it. Sometimes people mistake it for it, you know, not working for your skin. So you know, these things are something you need to keep in mind when you start with like really good skincare. That being said, let's get into the video. So this video is only going to have serums and moisturizers in this. There's not going to be any sunscreen products in this because I want to do a separate video for it. And there are a couple of sunscreens I'm currently trying. So I want to have like my proper thoughts on it and then make like a good proper sunscreen video which you can refer anytime you want. So serums are always made very, very light and thin in consistency so that they kind of get absorbed into the skin really, really quickly. So usually any serum you can use in winter and summer, there's no literally like, you know, season you have to use it. There are few serums which can be heavy, so maybe, you know, try and avoid that if your skin is not like, you know, able to take that in the summer. But these are the few serum recommendations which I really, really like and personally would recommend. You can use these in summer for sure as well. So the first one, it's kind of the most obvious one. Like if you see my skincare videos here and there, you kind of know this. It has like, it is one of my favorite serum, which is the Ordinary Niacinamide Serum. I love it. It did wonders for my skin and I really, really like this one. And especially in summer, you kind of tend to get more oily more quickly, right? And niacinamide kind of helps along with, you know, treating pigmentation. It also helps control the sebum production, helps your face from not getting really, really oily, etc. And the second serum I'm going to talk about is also a niacinamide, but this is an Indian brand. It's from Dr. Sheth. And I think it's a very good alternative for the Ordinary one. Like Ordinary one is way too expensive to get in India and Dr. Sheth one is really good. Again, no fragrance, no irritating ingredients. Everything I'm going to mention has no fragrance in it whatsoever. I feel like my skin cannot take fragrance. Like a little bit here and there is fine, but if I'm going to put like full on fragrance on my skin, it does not, like it cannot handle it. So I mostly prefer to find anything which is fragrance free, and that's, you know, what works well for me. So the first one is the Ordinary Niacinamide. The second one is the Dr. Sheth Centella and Niacinamide. Centella is very, very calming to the skin and very soothing to the skin. Again, niacinamide does wonders for pigmentation, sebum production, and overall giving you a very nice, healthy skin. Now, I do have a code for Dr. Sheth. You can check the description. I'll link everything. If I have a code, I'll drop it as well. So if you do want to use them, I'll get a little bit of commission. If you don't, that is perfectly fine. So the next serum I really like is the L'Oreal Hyaluronic Acid Serum. This serum is so thin in consistency. It just gets absorbed into your skin very, very well. Again, no fragrance, no comedogenic ingredients, and it does the job really well. And compared to the Ordinary one, I like this one because it just is so thin in consistency. Ordinary one is a little thicker. So, you know, I do really prefer the L'Oreal one. It gets absorbed into the skin and hydrates it and it nourishes it. Of course, if you live in dry area, then make sure you don't use it because hyaluronic acid sucks moisture from the air to keep you hydrated, right? But if you don't have enough moisture in your hair, it'll go in air, it'll suck it from you. So that is not good. If you live in a nice normal or humid area, then you can definitely go for this one. Then the next serum I really like is the Dr. Sheth Vitamin C Serum. Again, this is from their new range, which does not have any fragrance or any irritating ingredients. Now, I already have a video about my skincare favorites, which I've done like a long time ago, and I still really, really like them. So all these products are other than those products, just so that, you know, you get a new set of products which you want to try. And those products are still my favorite. You can definitely check that one out. In vitamin C, I only tried a couple of vitamin C's, and one of the ones I really like is the Claire's 5% vitamin C. But I really wanted to increase the percentage of it because I've been using 5% for a long time, and I think I can kind of step up. So I went with the 20% vitamin C, and I do really, really like it. And again, the consistency of the serum is so lightweight. Literally, the L'Oreal and the Dr. Sheth one are so thin that it just gets absorbed into the skin really, really quickly. And trust me, I think in like 2.5 weeks and 3 weeks that I've been using them, I did see a minor difference in my pigmentation. Of course, these things take a lot of time to, you know, work on your skin. Nothing is like instant, like you use 2 weeks and it gets better. But you slowly and gradually see a difference, and that one of that product is this vitamin C. Then the next one I've been really enjoying these days is the Pulp Night Serum. The ingredients are so beautiful. No fragrance, no comedogenic ingredients. It has ceramides, tons and tons of ceramides, which is really good to rejuvenate your skin and maintain that skin barrier. And I've actually been trying to get my hands in a good ceramide like moisturizer or a, you know, serum for me to like help repair my skin barrier. But I don't know, I've tried a couple, but I really didn't like any, and this is one which suited my skin very, very well, and I've been thoroughly loving it. I use it almost every night, and it's one of the most beautiful serums I've tried in the recent times, and I would definitely recommend this. So moving on to exfoliating serums, I'll only mention two serums here. So one is the Paula's Choice BHA. You get this on Amazon right now. Even if you don't want to buy on Instagram pages, you get it on Amazon as well, so you can buy it from there. 2% BHA is really good. I use this almost like once in 2-3 days, or once in or every alternate day. Like if I'm wearing too much makeup, then I kind of like use it alternate day. If not, then I use it once in 2-3 days. So BHA is something which exfoliates your skin from within. So I just take it on my hand. I don't even use a pad. I just take it on my hand and lightly dab it off, so that, you know, I don't have any clogged pores or anything. And that's a serum I would really recommend. It's quite expensive, I know, but it's a one-time investment, and it does last a really long time. It's a big bottle, and it does the job really well. The next serum I really like is the Earth Rhythm Lactic Acid 10% Serum. So that was a BHA which we spoke about, Paula's Choice, and lactic acid is an AHA. So while BHA like exfoliates from within, lactic acid exfoliates from the top layer of the skin. So if you have any dead cells, dead skin cells or anything, it's kind of going to exfoliate it like without having like a physical scrub or something. So again, this serum really good, no fragrance, no comedogenic ingredient. It gets absorbed into your skin really, really quickly, and lactic acid is a lot safer to use as well. So again, if you're a beginner, then be very careful when you use exfoliating ingredients, because your skin might not react well with it because you never used it. So do a patch test first, and 10% lactic acid is a very decent amount, and it suited my skin really, really well. So I don't use this every day. I feel like at a point I was over exfoliating my skin a lot, so I do this like once every 2-3 days. Like I've like placed my, you know, skin exfoliating things like that. Like previously I used to like have, you know, freak out so much, and I used to like exfoliate every single day. I used to like use some glycolic acid or BHA or something almost every single day on my skin in the night, but I stopped doing that. So I either do it every alternate days or every two to three days. On the rest of the days I just use like my normal pulp serum or something like that, and then add a moisturizer and get done with it. So these are the other two serums I really like in exfoliating ones. So that's it for the serums. I wanted the list to be short, because if it's like really long, it kind of gets very overwhelming and you would not understand what to buy. So all the serums I've mentioned in this video are like my favorite products, and I really like them, and I would definitely recommend them. So let's move on to moisturizers. And one of the moisturizers I absolutely love, I mean, it would not do any harm to your skin whatsoever, is the Clinique Moisture Surge. I stand by it. I thrive by it. I don't remember the word, but I really, really like that one. It's again fragrance free, non-comedogenic, and it hydrates your skin really well without making your skin feel really heavy. Like, you massage it in your skin and 1 minute it's gone, you don't even feel it, but moisturizes your skin really, really well. So there are moisturizers which get absorbed into your skin very quickly, but then again after 5 to 10 minutes you kind of start feeling very dry. That means they don't, like, you know, moisturize the skin really well. But this one is really good. So this one is actually really good for dry skin and oily skin, so it's like the perfect balance. But again, it's expensive. If you do want to invest in this one, then I would definitely, you know, suggest you to take it without, like, you know, second guessing it. When it comes to moisturizers, I think Clinique has really good ones, like any type. Like, you can even customize a few products according to you, which is really amazing. So if you have the budget to, you know, get that, then, you know, why not? You can definitely get any of the Clinique moisturizers. I think all of them are really good. The next moisturizer I really, really like is the Sugandha White Lotus moisturizer, the fragrance free version. Beautiful moisturizer, extremely lightweight on the skin. And there's one more moisturizer from Sugandha actually I really like, is also the aloe green tea gel. So aloe green tea gel, if you have dry skin you can use it as a serum, but if you have really oily skin then you can use that as a moisturizer. But if you have dry skin, then even Sugandha White Lotus one would not be enough. But if you have oily skin, these two would make your perfect, like, combination skin, oily skin. These would be like a perfect moisturizer for your skin. Extremely lightweight, no fragrance, no irritating ingredients. They just moisturize your skin and do the job very well. Next moisturizer I've been really loving for this in the past 4 to 5 months is the Be Minimalist Oat Plus Epica moisturizer. I've loved this moisturizer entire winter. In winter, my skin tends to be normal. If I use the aloe green tea gel during, like, winter, then my skin, it would not be enough for my skin. But the Be Minimalist one was like the perfect balance. Like, I could not use something which is extremely creamy because again it would be too heavy. If you have dry skin or normal skin, then I would definitely suggest you to go with the Be Minimalist one. So if you have oily skin, then try to stay in, like, you know, the Clinique, the Sugandha one. These are really nice ones. And the last one which I really like and I've been thoroughly loving is again the Olay Retinol moisturizer. But of course, this moisturizer was only supposed to be used in the night time, so you'll have to have another moisturizer for daytime. But this one works really well, again good for dry skin and the oily skin. And this retinol is really good for your skin. I would suggest this moisturizer only if you're like 23, 24 and above. Do not take this moisturizer if you're under, like, if you're a teenager or anything. You do not need like a retinol moisturizer right now. Like, if you have some skin issues and you want to deal with it, then that's like a different thing. Go to your doctor, talk to them about it. But if you just generally want a moisturizer, then and you're 24 plus, then you can really start, like, you know, putting retinol into your skincare one by one. So if you're 24 and above, then buy the Olay Retinol one. It's a really beautiful moisturizer, hydrates the skin, nourishes the skin, rejuvenates the skin, and does everything overall. I would give it a 10 out of 10. My mom actually finished the serum of this Olay Retinol range and her skin actually reacted really well to it as well. So you cannot use both together, of course. So you can either use the, you know, serum of the retinol Olay or the moisturizer from them. Okay, there's actually one more moisturizer I really like. Actually, two more. Both are from Requel. So there's an oil-free moisturizer from Requel, which is really good for, like, normal to oily skin. And there's like a ceramide one, which is good for dry skin. So I don't have it now with me, but I did use it when I had it and it was good. So only thing in this is it does have fragrance. So if, like, a fragrance is a big deal to you, then you cannot buy this. But if it's an okay thing, like, it did not react to my skin because it's, like, literally the last ingredient and very, very minute and not irritate my skin personally. But if it does to you, then you can avoid this, or else you can go for this one. It's a good, very good, nice, affordable moisturizer. So yeah guys, that's it for the video. Like I told you, I wanted the list to be really small because I didn't want it to be very, very overwhelming. I wanted to just put products I absolutely love and swear by. Now I got the word swear by. Which product was I going to talk about? Like Clinique wala? Swear by? which product? Anyway, the word I wanted to use that time was swear by. So anyways, that's it for this video. I'll post the sunscreen video really, really soon. I think in like 1 or 2 weeks. So do look out for that if you're looking for really good sunscreen recommendations. Until then, please stay safe. Please stay at home. Please wear a mask. If you're going outside, please wear a double mask. And do not go out if it's not necessary at all. We are in a really, really difficult times. And I am here to try to create content to make you feel better, but you have to be careful, you have to be responsible so that all of us can get out of this really, really soon. And yeah, with that, we finish this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and I hope this video was useful. And if you like the video, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.